Lee?
Well, Mr. President, thank you. It's not just awareness that you and your administration have towards the issue that we're facing in Suffolk County on Long Island, but you have proven that you will do absolutely everything in your power to address a very personal issue for us. Last year, we had one woman in Greenport on the North Fork of Long Island who was murdered, allegedly, by a person who was an illegal immigrant, was removed from our country, and returned again. And we're just hearing the story of the Indianapolis Colt player who was murdered and was killed as well in the crash. It's a matter of physical security, quality of life. It's a top priority for us, and you're going to do everything in your power, and we appreciate it. Just last week, a school board in my district was forced to take action against its own town for $10.5 million in costs incurred due to massive overcrowding in local schools. Last year, 498 motel rooms in Hampton Bays were occupied by illegal immigrants who use this housing year-round. Residents have asked the town of Southampton to enforce the town's safety codes and force the motel owners to comply with local law enforcement. And in Hampton Bays, as a result, years later, of one year after another of Southampton Town not doing the right thing with code enforcement, MS-13 is committing heinous crimes in Hampton Bays, in the town of Southampton. And we hear in the news when the horrific murder that took place of four constituents, two from my district, two from Pete's district, with machetes. The crimes that we don't read about, where murder doesn't take place, with the human trafficking and the sex trafficking and drug trafficking, it's all so important, your focus. And a great appointment in Rich Donahue, the new U.S. Attorney for the Eastern District, a former 82nd Airborne Division paratrooper, and we're excited because he cares deeply about combating this MS-13. Chain migration, visa lottery, the temporary protected status, all these issues that we're talking about, having a border wall, making sure it's funded, temporary protected status, temporary. Why is it that 16 years later, someone would be in our country under something called temporary protected status? It proves that something's wrong with our immigration system. We're talking about unaccompanied minors? In that Central American country where that parent chooses to turn their kid over for a dangerous mission to the United States. And along that journey, maybe before they get to the border, we hear these stories in the Yaphan Correctional Facility held at gunpoint. They have to smuggle narcotics across the border if they want to complete their mission. They are the entire process from the moment their parents turn them over to when they end up, say, in Brentwood, they're completely set up for failure. And America is a compassionate country. We have compassion for every child who's living in poverty, oppression, gang violence, anywhere in the world. But we don't have the bandwidth for every parent to turn their kids over for this mission and to come to our country. And one other thing that I know that you deeply believe and you're passionate about is that the American dream and hope and opportunity and everything that we want for people who come to our country believing in American exceptionalism, that this is the greatest country in the world, what about the person who's not here yet? Because they went to their local consulate and they said, I want to pursue the American dream for my family. And because they're following the rules, that they should wait in line behind the people who violated them is absolutely wrong. The Project Safe Neighborhoods was brought up. This is an important initiative for our county as well. $500,000, it was amazing how far $500,000 went in Suffolk County to support our local law enforcement. You also helped secure through DOJ the designate of MS-13 as a target of the Organized Crime Drug Enforcement Task Forces. It's a nationwide effort that utilizes the resources and expertise of our leading law enforcement agencies to disrupt and dismantle major drug traffickers, the way that they're getting a lot of their money. And last Congress, Congress also reauthorized money for the Bulletproof Vest Partnership Grant Program with bipartisan support. And to echo one other point that was just mentioned, if someone is applying for status and they are a gang member and they get naturalization and for whatever reason it was not known that they committed a serious offense and they're involved in gang activity, they should lose their naturalization if they were not honest in their application process. And if it's 2 years later or 7 years later, even if they were completely honest on their application that they hadn't committed offenses in the past,
if 5 years later they're involved in a gang and they commit a serious offense, well then take away their naturalization. Because there's a duty when you're here, if you're given the opportunity to stay, to be productive citizens and members of our great country. And once again, thank you on behalf of a region of our country that desperately needed your leadership. We know that we have it. We know that you have our back.
I do.
And thank you.
Thank you deeply. Very much, Lee.